There's only one way, practicing a lot of mock tests. Like I used to practice at least one test a day before the exam. So I never made a timetable because I never followed it. So I never had a timetable, but I would fix study hours daily. But when I came home and I checked up with the answer key, I realized that all questions were correct and then I was very happy.
Hello, everybody. Today we have with us Karthika Ji Nair, who managed to win the perfect score of 720 in the Neet 2021. She has her roots from Kerala and now lives in Mumbai. Let's hear from her how she managed to achieve this. So were you expecting a perfect score? What was your reaction right after the exam?
So after the exam, like I wasn't sure about the around 4 to 5 questions and I had expected somewhere around 680 plus. But when I came home and I checked up with the answer key, I realized that all questions were correct and then I was very happy.
How was your preparation for this exam? What exactly did you do to get this mark?
So basically, my preparation consisted of relying on NCERT books and the mock test for preparation. I had practiced a lot of mock tests before the exam so that I'm getting used to the pattern. And I used to plan daily goals for my preparation and read NCERT many times. And then I had enrolled in coaching institute, that is Akash Institute, for my preparation in the year 2019.
Oh, wonderful. So you mentioned that you had set up daily goals. So did you have any timetable or was it just keeping up to the goals that you had set? How did it work?
So I never made a timetable because I never followed it. So I never had a timetable, but I would fix study hours daily. Like I increase it from 8 to 10 to finally 12. And if plans were, I would just make a list of what topics I had to cover that day. And at the end of the day, I would just check what was my progress. And then accordingly, I would plan the goals for the next day.
Okay. So how has this pandemic affected your studies?
So I started my preparation in 2019 and the first year went smooth without any lockdown. But when I came to class 12, the lockdown was announced and suddenly, you know, all your classes were shifted to laptops and mobiles. And that was something we had never experienced because like we never really have an online, we never really had online classes before. So you're not seeing your teachers, you're not having your friends around. So that was really troublesome in the start. But eventually you get used to it. And then it was very good because I could, actually get used to it. And then I could follow the things properly. And then I could understand the things properly as well.
Okay. So what was the biggest challenge during this exam and how did you tackle it?
I think there are two problems. First of all, it is the time management. And second, the marking on the OMR sheet because you have to mark 180 responses on the OMR. And if you make mistakes in it, that would be very bad because if you're solving it correctly on the question paper and marking the response wrong, nothing can be worse compared to it. So that's one thing. And second thing is time management because you have, this year we had 200 questions. You had to attempt only 180, but you had only 180 minutes to solve the question, check it again and mark it on the OMR response. So that made things difficult. And to overcome these challenges, there is only one way, practicing a lot of mock tests. Like I used to practice at least one test a day before the exam. So that helped a lot in, you know, managing the time properly.
That's nice. So which was your favorite subject? Was it biology?
Yes, biology, specifically zoology. I love it because I found it easier to remember the facts of zoology.
Okay. And what about the other subjects? Or which was the hardest of them all?
It was physics because I'd always had a problem in it ever since I'd started with my preparation. And I believe it's the same case with most of the NEET aspirants. And it's because physics involves a lot of calculations and I'm bad at it. And, there are more chances of silly mistakes in physics. And another thing is that always I used to lose my marks somewhere or the other in physics itself. That's why I always had this dislike for the subject, but you don't have any other choice. You have to do it.
So you managed to get a 98.8 percentile for JEE. Tell us about it.
So even though I'd taken PCMB in school, engineering was never really in front of my eyes. It was always medicine from the very start. But my teachers had asked me to, apply for JEE Main because that would be a good practice for NEET because there are two common subjects, physics and chemistry. And JEE Main and NEET both are conducted by the same agency, NTA. So my teachers had told me that you'd get a good experience of a test conducted by NTA itself and hence you should enroll in JEE Main exam. I didn't specifically prepare anything for JEE Main. I just did what I do for NEET and I went there for NEET exam.
Okay. Was it always your dream to be a doctor?
Yes, from the very beginning, like ever since I knew what a doctor was, I always wanted to become that because I think it's the most, wonderful profession in this world. It's the most amazing profession in the world, the most blessed profession in this world. That's why I'd always wanted to be this ever since my childhood.
This is the first step for your dream to come true. How do you feel about it?
Like, it's such an amazing feeling. Like, I was blown away when I realized that at the first rank, because I've always dreamt of being the first ranker, but never really imagined that would be possible. So, like, standing here, it feels so good. And looking at my journey ahead, it feels even more good because, like, finally, I'll be able to study in my dream college and prepare for MBBS and finally do a PG in the stream I love.
Oh. Do you have any tips for the students preparing for NEET?
So I'd say that, first of all, you should practice a lot of mock tests, like as many as you can, because that is very important. And that is how you can, you know, plan out your strategy and, you know, find out which strategy works best for you. And then you should rely on NCERT books. I mean, you should read NCERT several times. And then you should practice previous year questions, like at least 5 years question before the exam, so that you have an idea of which topics are more important. But one thing is very important to understand, that all topics are important, because even one question from a topic is, like, even if one question comes from a topic, that will also be very important. And second thing is that you never need to get stressed out because of this. Because if you, like, before the exam, it feels such a significant thing. But standing here, it feels so insignificant because it's just the first phase of your life. There is a lot to go ahead. And so never stress about it. Just be cool and calm and relax and practice a lot. That's it.
Oh, okay. You said not to stress out. So how did you manage your pressure?
So, sometimes when there was, so much together, like, when too many things come together, there was a lot of pressure. So my parents were always around to help me out. They would say that don't worry, because if you get worried, the things will, become more stressful. And nothing good is going to come out of it. So you should always be cool and just say that, okay, everything will come out good in the end.
Oh, nice. Okay, so what are your future plans?
So I want to study MBBS in AIIMS Delhi, and then I love to take a PG in maybe oncology or neurology, but I'm not decided that because I think there's a lot of time for that.
Okay. Well, that's wonderful. Thank you so much, Karthika, and all the best.
Thank you so much.